Honorable Minister for Finance and Corporate Affairs, Nirmala Sitharaman ji, President Harshpati Singhania, C.K. Ranganathan, my guru and mentor, Azim Prem ji, my friend Sanjeev Mehta, and of course, Dr. Randeep Guleria, who's saving many of us from the crisis we are in the middle of. And ladies and gentlemen, first of all, madam, thank you for your very invigorating words and actions. Let me step back and actually think about the world we leave behind in hindsight of 2020. As I look at the year ahead and the years ahead, I see three critical challenges and opportunities for the world. The first is to quickly move to a post-COVID world. And the faster we do it to get into the post-pandemic era, the better it is. And the world and India has taken up the challenge of vaccination. And I do hope we can vaccinate our people as soon as possible and embark upon the new journey. I go back to 100 years ago, which, madam, you mentioned in the context of the budget, which truly has turned out to be outstanding. And I think about the Spanish flu, and post that, from 1920s, the world economy had what was known as the Roaring Twenties. I would like to see the world and India get into the Roaring Twenties of 2021 and beyond. And for us to get there, I think one of the most critical aspects is to get COVID behind us and under control as soon as possible. Therefore, the biggest opportunity and challenge for us is to get the vaccination done as soon as possible. So that is one big critical item for our future. The second one, madam, the world has taken us to a point where geography is history. I do see that in that context, India making a play for getting a fair share of the factory of the world, because factories can be anywhere. They don't need to be only dominant to the east of India. They can be very much in India, and the steps taken to encourage setting up factories into India so that India can also compete for being one of the major factories of the world is a very positive step. And I think your encouragement to business and industry to make India move in the direction of the factory of the world is the right step at this crucial juncture. I also, however, see another major opportunity in the context of geography being history, and that is India becoming the office of the world, not the back office, but the front and back office of the entire world. And why do I say that this is the opportunity beckoning us? Thanks to connectivity, thanks to COVID, we have realized and recognized the power of the digital and the virtual world. A person, if we can train and educate in the smallest village of India and give connectivity with technical knowledge and skill, that person can serve any company, any business, anywhere in the world. A small villager can be an outstanding engineer for a Google, Microsoft, or any other company, not only in America, but also in any part of India. Therefore, truly, if we can grasp the opportunity coming out of the pandemic, where geography is history, we can transform the world in a new manner in the context of the theme of today and what Prime Minister and you have always encouraged: transformation is key. Therefore, India has an opportunity to also be the office of the world. And the third point, which I think you have in many ways looked at in the and addressed in the context of your budget, is humanity and the world have gone in for disproportionate borrowing from the future in two areas. One is environment, and the second is money. And the pandemic has accentuated that even more. The time has come for us as the present generation to ensure that the borrowings we have done from environment, both present and past, we have an obligation to repay it back in good time so that the future generation does not get destroyed out of sustainability damage we would have done to planet Earth. And in that context, your focus on some key areas in the area of sustainability, as also in the area of healthcare, sanitation, and various other aspects, are crucial for building a strong and a sustainable India, and an India which is committed to nature and planet Earth. The second aspect about sustainable of borrowing from the future is the world at large, and India too, has had to borrow from the future for saving ourselves from the pandemic. And here your budget, which has focused on expenditure, moving away from revenue expenditure to creating more towards investment in infrastructure, which will create real assets for the future generation, is a right transformational change in the mix of how we are spending from the monies which we rightly owe to the future generation. And we must continue down that path because we owe it to them. And it is here that I would also like to say that what the government has done in the last few months is once again reiterate that there is a great conviction that enterprise and growth go together. And the signals which you have given and the mindset shift which you have told for Indian enterprise to have, that the government is as much committed to private sector as it is to public sector. We want to create jobs, we want to create opportunity. And the biggest aspect about the communication from the Prime Minister and you, Madam Finance Minister, that the time has come for us to celebrate enterprise, to celebrate creators of value and wealth for the country. And we must increase the size of the cake, which is crucial at this point of time in our history. The extremely important step which you have taken not to tinker with taxes in this budget is very appreciated, and you put a serious onus on business and industry now to respond and take up the challenge of making growth come back big time. And I just wanted to, in that context, also mention that the role which the government in coordination with RBI has played to ensure that the interest rates remain stable is also extremely important for what has been done, and also over the next 12 to 18 months. We need to ensure that as the size of the borrowing program goes up, we are able to keep the long-term interest rates on the basis of which business and industry take the investment decisions also remain in a reasonable range so that long-term investment decisions can be taken. I understand it is a challenging thing because you're managing many different variables, but I think a stable tax rate and a reasonable range for long-term interest rates will really help business and industry to take long-term investment decisions. All in all, I would like to say India is at a critical journey, and we have taken some bets. We have taken a call that we will define the destiny of India in a manner which gives us a cutting-edge position in the Committee of Nations. And I would like to state on my behalf, and I'm sure from my colleagues in business and industry, that our time is now. And the reach out with the government is done, that government and business and industry work hand in hand and shoulder by shoulder is the message which I think we must take it forward. And I am very confident about the future of India. Many of us have taken long-term bets on India and its future, and we are deeply committed to make India, the nation state, one of the greatest in the world. So we are with you in this journey. And I would like to state for all my colleagues that, my dear friends and colleagues, we now really need to get our animal spirits back, and we will have to do a lot more than applause. The time has come for us to walk the talk. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.